Good evening. They had been dreaming of that match and those magnificent moments their entire lives. 23 women, fast, fearless, and now the most famous in the country. Their thrilling 2-0 win over Denmark, delighting the nation, but more importantly, inspiring millions of young girls and boys. And the story of the Magic Matildas is not over yet. Next stop, the quarterfinals.
Up till late, but the Tillies were still up and about early this morning.
How are you?
Yeah, it was amazing.
Their eyes already on the next game.
Ready for the next one?
Absolutely.
There wasn't much sleep after this do-or-die clash against Denmark. The Matildas didn't disappoint in front of a home crowd of more than 75,000 as they got the scoring started with this magic pass from Mary Fowler to Caitlin Ford. One up in the second half, the Tillies continued to dazzle the Danish. In the 71st minute, Hayley Rasso delivered a second goal, her third of the tournament. Fans in a frenzy from Melbourne's Federation Square. Across to Adelaide's Festival Plaza. In Brisbane, they flocked to South Bank and hundreds packed in along Sydney's Darling Harbour. Screams almost drowned out when Sam Kerr made it onto the field for the first time this World Cup.
Just seeing her take the bib off and get ready to run on, we're so excited.
An awkward slip had fears she'd be re-injured, but the captain is shaking it off, hoping to run on again on Saturday.
One game at a time. Obviously the dream is there, but one game at a time.
Loyal fans were up first thing this morning to wave off their heroes.
Do you want to be in the Matildas one day?
Yeah, for sure.
For the Tillies, today was for travel. Training is back on tomorrow. As for which team they'll play in the quarterfinal, that'll be decided tonight when France plays Morocco. The whole country still basking in the green and gold as millions rally behind the girls to make it to the semis and beyond. Samara Gardner for 10 News First.
I want to bring in our football specialist now, Benz Hamerly. And Benz, you've been following this team for some time. What a bonus to have the captain back too.
Well, Sandra, absolutely. And what's the World Cup been missing? It's Sam Kerr. And finally, she got on the field last night. She played 15 minutes against Denmark, back from that calf injury, which has been the centre of so much intrigue. She says, everyone in Australia's a physio. I didn't realise. But she's back now, which means Australia's really beautifully positioned. She comes into a team that's absolutely flying in front of goal, goals against Canada and Denmark now. And Tony Gustafsson may well lose some of his amazing hair because it means, unfortunately, that one of the players who's been playing really well probably loses their position in the team. It'd be incredibly harsh to think it's Mary Fowler or Emily Van Egmond, but that's not the way this team thinks, and they know that it takes a squad to win the World Cup. Hopefully that's the journey that they're on. So whichever 11 women are picked for that next game in Brisbane, the other 22 will be right behind them. They really play for each other. It's a selfless team. And the rest of the country will be behind them too, obviously, Sandra. We'll have an extended chat with Sam in sport, as well as some of the other stars from last night.
And we've certainly got plenty of depth in this side.
Absolutely, and everyone's, you know, kicking and the dream's alive.
We love it. All right, thank you, Benz.